welcome Madison Hubbell and Zachary Donohue.
So now for America, two 21-year-olds who were 10th in the world last year, so plenty of pedigree behind these two. A waltz and a polka, starting with the soundtrack from Titanic for Madison Hubbell, Zachary Donohue. Lovely start, quality in the edges, difficulty in the twizzles. Just a slight slip.
Don't stand your ground, friend, don't you fall. The excise men, they're at the wall. Jesus Christ, they're bringing us all. In the hills of
well, the variety of rhythms are giving force to some really enjoyable skating, and that continues with Madison Hubbell and Zachary Donohue there.
Ladies and gentlemen, mesdames et messieurs.
Madison used to compete with her brother at international junior level, but now with Zachary, very much a fixture on the senior scene, 10th in the world, as I said. So looking in this, their second season, to really break through.
As you would expect, we've really moved up a gear here with the actual theming of the routine has got more sophistication to it from my perspective. It's a two-parter, so a waltz from the Titanic for the start, and then John Ryan's polka as the second. So it gives each, within the 2 minutes 50, each piece of music a little bit more time to breathe, and they made the most of that. Twizzles were very well done indeed. The start had a lovely flow to it. Here we go, looking at the twizzles, a jump which makes it more difficult to do the initial setup for them. Looking at a forward outside twizzle, holding the foot at the back makes it more difficult, increases the level of difficulty, and well done. Very good relationship. he's presenting her all the time. 6 seconds, remember, in the lift. I think the rules should be changed. I think ice dancing, from a lift point of view, is one of the most dangerous, forcing the skaters to do incredibly acrobatic moves in a very tight timescale, and the girls do get bad shoulder injuries. I think it's completely silly that you have to do a lift within a number of seconds when you dance to the beat of the music. It forces you to do it out of time. It forces you to do something very, very acrobatic, and I think it's dangerous, and it really should be looked at throughout in the ice dancing. I just think it's daft.
Shall I kick the soapbox from under you right now?
You've done that, okay. The step sequence, the running into the step sequence was lovely. The transition there. I wasn't that keen on the changing out of syncopation at the end of the step sequence, but it all worked. Really well presented routine. I think they'll be happy with it. Well done, team.
And they do look good on the ice, both of them. Being groomed for big success, these two. And it could be theirs this year.
The difficulty in the lift they put in with the change of positions, the balance on the foot, the going up. The blade is so sharp. He gets that wrong, or she gets that wrong, and there's a slip, and it's a cut of the leg. But he got it up and down in the 6 seconds. She actually came off the stand onto the leg, straight down onto the ice. So you've got to choreograph with a stopwatch in one hand,
yes,
and looking at what's going on in the other.
No, I've got it, Nikki. I've got it.
Yep. It's the lift. Shall I stop now?
I think we're there. I must say, I'm not sure about the blade on the thigh. It still worries me.
Well, yes.
'54-'84. That's going to take them into the lead. We have moved up a class, that's for sure. So Hubble and Donoghue lead. Gilles Poirier in second place. Just one mark by.